Dictionaries are one of the options when you want to store and manage items in a collection. The speciality of the dictionary is that it stores each item with an associated key. So let's have a look at this example. The typical setup would be that you manage a dictionary between two pads with the same name that give you read and write access to it. Now, when you want to insert an item in the dictionary, you have to provide what is called a key value pair. So instead of only providing the item itself, you also have to provide a key. In this example, I've decided that my keys would be strings and the items would be colors, but the dictionary is generic, so it really works with any data types for both keys and items. So let's see, I have a key color one that I want to associate with this green color. I add it to the dictionary and you see it's already in there. Now I'm creating another key. I'm choosing another color, add that. And I do this a third time with a different color again, add that. Now we have three items in the dictionary. And notice that the keys have to be unique. So if I try to add another item with the same key, then simply nothing happens. Now it's easy to remove items from the dictionary. You simply have to provide the key that you want to remove. So in this case, color one, I remove it. You see, it's gone. I want to remove the key color three, and it's gone. Then there is the set item operation, which you can call on a dictionary. It kind of has two functionalities. First, it lets you change the item of an existing key. So in this case, key two is already existing. If I change the color, you see it's simply changing the value here. But the other functionality the set item has is that it also allows you to add items. So if I call set item with a key that does not exist yet, you see the item is added. So far we have added, modified, and removed items from the dictionary, but often we also just want to recall a value given a specified key, and this is what the try-get value is for. So you give it a key, and it tells you whether the item exists, and if it exists, it also returns the item itself. So the key foo does not exist, as we know, but a key color 2 will exist, and also the key color 3 will exist. It tells us, yes, the item exists, and this is the actual item. If you're only interested in the fact if a key exists or not, then you can also use the contains key operation here. Color 2 exists. Then we have a count node that simply tells us how many items there are currently in the dictionary. And finally, sometimes we are not really interested in the fact that these items are stored as key value pairs. We simply want a list of all the values or a list of all the keys in the dictionary. And this is what we can use the keys and values nodes for, which simply returns a sequence of strings in this case because the keys are of type string. And here we get a sequence of type RGBA because the values are all colors.